Good morning everyone. A very warm welcome to each and every one of you present in today's GK class of Standard 7th. As we have come across, that is approximately more than 1 week has been passed, your unit test is over and still we are awaiting for the results, and I hope you are going to get the results very soon. Okay. Before going ahead with today's syllabus, as we have done in the last class, that is first we discussed the syllabus, I showed you the syllabus and I told you till where we have done, what are we going to plan today and each and everything. In the similar way, the same thing I am going to do today as well. First I'll be sharing you the syllabus, thereafter I'll be going ahead with the bookish part and finally the current affairs, and that's it. And one more thing, I have something for you, some of the pictures which I would prefer to show to you, as this will be beneficial for you as well. Okay. And I hope this is also an activity also which you can do, and this is going to help you a lot. Okay. So starting with this, let me first warn you, that is if you would have read day before yesterday's newspaper, okay, so you would come across, that is second time, that is on 31st of August, our country experienced the highest number of COVID cases, and day before yesterday, that is 2 days back on Wednesday as well, okay, our country experienced the second highest number of cases in one day, that was around 79,000 or something. Okay, so still the what you can say, that is that fear factor has not gone yet, though our the virus for this COVID-19 virus has decreased its power. It is not that much powerful as compared to earlier, but still the number of cases and the infections are not at all in a controlled manner, or they are not in a controlled environment. So it is my humble request from each and every one of you to pay utmost care, take all the necessary precautions so that you as well as your family remains on a safer side, and at the same time our daily routine activities, our daily life, as well as our happy life and everything, whatever it is, okay, it does not get affected by this pandemic situation created by COVID-19 or the difficult circumstances which can come as a result of this COVID-19. I hope this is clear to each and everyone. So without any delay, a lot more explanation has been done. Regarding one more thing, that is I would like to say, that is the June classes which are there, maybe that is in your second week or the fourth week, I will not be able to take the classes due to some unavoidable reason, and after 25th, that is after 25th of September, I'll be taking that Zoom classes and I will be planning some of the activities to do there. Okay, so before going ahead with this, let me just share the screen with you first and the foremost thing, and thereafter let me show you this part. That is what I remember is that in the last class we have completed this sports and entertainment, these three pages, that is page number 28, 33 and 36, and thereafter, since we have completed this part, so now the last part, that is your brain workout. But if you see the brain workout, this is the same brain workout which was given in periodic test 1, which we have already completed. So without any delay, let us start our annual portion. But annual portion also, class, remember that we are not going to start as it is, that is we are not going to start from here. First and the foremost thing, as we were doing in the school, we will be first completing our periodic test 2, that is these page numbers, and thereafter we will be going ahead with the remaining ones, which are the portions of your half yearly reason. Okay, so without any delay, let us start with our environment. Let me first little bit brief you about this environment, and thereafter, and most probably I hope today we will be doing only these two page numbers, that is your page number 42 and 47, the two page numbers of our environment. Okay, so first and the foremost thing, what is environment? What is environment? Do you know? Okay, all of you know this thing, but how to explain it, or how to just define it? Okay, so environment is nothing but the sum total of interactions between your abiotic and biotic factors. Okay, when we are talking about biotic and abiotic factors, so what are these? In geography also you would have studied this part, that is what are biotic and abiotic factors, or in science as well. Okay, so basically biotic or abiotic factors are those factors, that is biotic. Okay, since let me show you this part, First, let me share the screen with you. Let me explain you this part. Okay. See here. As the word biotech. Okay. This biotech word is made up of two words, that is your bio plus tech. Okay. And the meaning of this bio word is living. Okay. This is how you will be remembering or try to remember what is the meaning of this biotech. Bio means living. Okay. So the meaning of this bio is what? Living here. Okay. So if the meaning of bio is living, tick basically you can refer to the organisms or anything, things. Okay. So living things basically. In the same way you have for your abiotic as well. Okay, but we don't have anything, it is just abiotic, nothing. It is also made up of two words, that is your abio and your tick. Here also it is common. So abio means not living. So abio, just remember one thing and the second will be automatically just opposite of it. So abiotic is basically nothing, that is it is depicting us or telling us about the non-living things which are present here. Okay. So biotech means we are talking about all those living components which are present in our environment, and abiotic we are talking about all those components which are non-living in our environment. So is that clear? I hope everyone. Okay. So now if we move ahead with this part. So this is how our environment is together made up of these two factors, that is your biotic and abiotic. Okay. Now these two factors. Okay, a lot of interaction is there in between, or how human life is survival or how the organisms are surviving. Okay, so each and every organism is surviving just on the basis of the interactions which are taking place between biotic and abiotic factors. Okay, I'm giving you very common examples basically here. Okay, so first let me share the screen, then I'll be showing you this part. Okay. So if we see here, what I'm going to explain you is, that is, we were, okay, we have two parts, that is your biotic, we have the second part, that is your abiotic. Okay, now these two are the factors. Okay. If all both these factors, that is which we are talking about here, okay, that is your biotic and abiotic factors, both these factors, they are interrelated amongst each other. How they are interrelated, let us see. In the case of biotic, what are the examples which we can have? The examples can be your like plants, animals, and all those microorganisms which are using or eating something and taking air as the life sustaining gas. Okay, they are your biotic factors. Abiotic means all those factors which are non-living, like your air is there, water is there, mountains are there, and everything. Okay, now how they are interacting among themselves. Now see, I'm showing you with the help of this one. Okay, now see, biotic organisms, they are dependent on abiotic organisms. Okay, for example, how? Just by, if you can see, each and every biotic organism requires oxygen, one thing. Okay, so from where they are getting this oxygen? From atmosphere only. So this oxygen is what? Oxygen is nothing but the abiotic factor. So biotic factor is using the abiotic factor, that is one example is oxygen. Okay, how abiotic factors are being dependent on biotic factors, this also you see. In the case of abiotic factors, what do you find? That all these abiotic factors here, if we put the arrow here. Okay, so in this case, if you remember, like if we take the example of plants here, so all of you know that plants require carbon dioxide, you know, each and everyone. Okay, plant require carbon dioxide. So this plant is going to get carbon dioxide from where? It is going to get from abiotic factors only. Or how this abiotic factor is dependent, that is all of you know, that is whatever plants are there, they are going to take this component carbon dioxide from the atmosphere only. And carbon dioxide is also nothing but it is abiotic factors only. So this is how the interaction between biotic and abiotic factors are there. Okay, and it is just because of these interactions only that the life is possible. Otherwise the life would not have been possible on this surface of the earth. Okay, that is each and every biotic and abiotic factors, they are interrelated amongst each other. Okay, so this was there. If we move ahead with this, okay, so this is basic concept of your environment, and the study of environment is known as ecology. Remember, okay, ecology, this is the study of environment. Okay, remember the word, or I can show you here only. Ecology. Okay, this is the study of environment is known as your ecology. Okay, so this was there for the introduction of this our environment part. Now let us move ahead with the bookish part. Okay. The very first one, that is, I told you we will be doing only two page numbers, that is your marine world, that is page number 42 and 47. Okay, so I'm sharing the screen and let us see here. This marine world, when we are talking about, so marine world basically refers to the aquatic world or aquatic organisms. Aquatic organism includes your both the plants as well as the animals which are present in the water bodies and how they are interacting amongst themselves. Is that clear? So now let us move ahead with this, how we are going to do this thing. The very first one, if you can see, identify these marine animals and write their names in the blanks. Choose your answers from the help box. Okay, so the very first one is your lamprey. Okay, next one is your cuttlefish. Okay, if you can see, the structure only is quite dangerous looking, okay, or scary. Next one, that is, this is your krill. Next, porpoise, just like looking like your whales or dolphins as well, but dolphins have a quite long beak this side. Okay, so something what like whale you can say. This, if you can see, this is completely looking like a drawing, but this is not actually a drawing. This is the sea anemone. Next one we have, if you can see, this is not looking like any of the organisms. It can be your what do we call it? Just by looking we can say that this is some kind of waste which is present inside the sea, on the floor of the sea, or some kind of plants are there, but this is actually sea cucumber. Okay, this is your sponge. Okay, and this one your barracuda. Okay, if you can see the shape of this, so this is somewhat resembling your aeroplanes as well. Okay, not very much, but still shape is quite similar to them, and it is little bit different from your normal fishes or your any other aquatic fishes which we have seen till now. Okay, krills, when we are talking about this organism, so these krills are tiny, but they serve as an integral part of the marine food chain in Antarctic waters. Now see this part, food chain. If you remember food chain, you all have studied in class 6th. Okay, when you have studied the chapter food and health, most probably in that chapter only you have studied about the food chain. So food chain is what? It is nothing but the interdependency of one organisms on other. Interdependency of one organisms on other means what? That is, one organism is dependent on other organisms for its survival. Okay, next one, if we can see here, so they are the main food source for penguins, whales and fish in the region. The krill population in the waters near Antarctica has declined significantly since the 1970s as a result of decrease of sea ice coverage caused by climate change. Now what you can see here is that your krills there, they were very lot in number, that is the number of these krills, they were quite more, and as a result of which they were the basic food items for your these bigger fishes, that is like whales, dolphins and all these things. But since due to this global warming, the ice has started melting. So since the ice has started melting, so these organisms, the decrease in its population, that is this part, sorry, this one, the krill organism or the number of krills in the water bodies has decreased to a greater extent. And you know that since this is one of the major food sources for your whales, dolphins and other, so if this is going to decline or their number is going to decrease, so of course after few days the dependent organisms, matlab inke upar jo log dependent hain, like your whales, dolphins and everything, their number is also going to decrease only. Okay, so now let us move ahead to the next page number. Okay, animal facts. Okay, animals, remember we are also included in this category only of animals. Okay, against the following statements, write true, T for true and F for false in the boxes. A wolf can howl solo for up to 14 seconds. Okay, this is completely true, and 14 seconds is quite a long time if you can see. That is for, if you try to just stop your breath for 14 seconds and see whether you are able to do it or not. Okay, so when you are continuously speaking, say you are shouting continuously for 14 seconds. Okay, this is same. Okay, wolf is howling or you are shouting continuously for 14 seconds. So just try to do that and see whether you are able to do or not. Or just try to say a single word in a single breath for up to 14 seconds and check it out whether you are able to do it or not. Okay, the platypus is considered to be a kind of duck. That is false. The cries of a blue whale can be louder than a jet engine. This is completely true. The Kodiak bear is the largest living carnivore on land. That is your completely true. Bactrian camels are found in Africa. False. Manatees are marine animals that live along the Atlantic coast. True. The genetic blueprint of chimpanzees comes closest to that of the humans. This is also true. And horses are the fastest land animals. This is your false. Okay. Now see, I hope ostrich is the fastest. Okay, most probably ostrich is the fastest one. Let us see here. I would like to tell you something about this chimpanzee part, which we have studied in our higher classes. Basically, what you will find is that these chimpanzees, that is, if you see, they are more or less very much similar to the humans. And it was believed, जैसे ये पहले माना जाता था और जो हम लोग का evolutionary point of view है, that is, हम लोग ये मानते हैं कि all of a sudden human beings का development नहीं हुआ, ठीक है, या human beings नहीं आए. The life originated in water bodies, ठीक है, पानी में life धीरे धीरे originate हुआ, छोटे छोटे organisms, और यही छोटे छोटे organisms बड़े होते होते एक complex organism like us human beings हो गए. So earlier the humans or basically the nomads, early peoples, जैसे कि हम लोग चार पैर पे चलते थे, that is we were not using a proper hand, जैसे chimpanzee लोग चलते हैं, ठीक है, तो वैसे ही हम लोग भी क्या करते थे कि अपने चारों वो हमारे चारों पैर रहते थे, हम उन्हीं पे चलते थे. पर धीरे धीरे क्या हुआ कि हमने क्या किया, दो पैरों पे अपने बैलेंस को मेंटेन किया और फिर ये दो हाथ का यूज़ करने लगे, ठीक है, तो इसीलिए क्या हुआ कि पैरों का यूज़ खाली चलने के लिए हो गया और इससे हम और भी दूसरे काम करने लगे, ठीक है. सो दिस इज हाउ एवोल्यूशन इज अकरिंग. एंड एवरी मोमेंट द व्हेन यू विल बी स्टडिंग इन योर हायर क्लासेस, मतलब हर एक जनरेशन में कुछ ना कुछ एवोल्यूशन हो ही रहा है, ठीक है. आप देखते हो कि आजकल छोटे छोटे बच्चों को क्या हो रहा है, ठीक है, आई साइट की प्रॉब्लम हो जाती है, ठीक है, हाइट नहीं बढ़ती है, ठीक है, बाल बहुत जल्दी झड़ने लगते हैं, ठीक है, या फिर एजिंग का इफेक्ट दिखता है, एवरेज लाइफ पीरियड क्या हो रहा है, रिड्यूस होता जा रहा है, ठीक है. तो दिस इज़ नथिंग बट अ काइंड ऑफ एवोल्यूशन इज ओनली, ठीक है. और जैसे अगर आप थोड़ा सा शास्त्रों में जाएँ, ठीक है, जैसे मुझे भी बहुत ज़्यादा नॉलेज नहीं है, लेकिन ऐसा मैंने किसी से सुना है कि जैसे एक ये मतलब जो हमारा कलयुग है या फिर ये धरती है जो फिर से एक बार पुनर्जन्म जब होगा, तो ये जो ह्यूमन बींग्स हैं छोटे छोटे होते होते जब एकदम से छोटे हो जाएंगे साइज के, इतने बड़े बड़े जैसे हमने कुछ मूवीज में भी देखे हैं, ठीक है, एकदम छोटे छोटे ह्यूमन बींग्स हो जाएंगे, ठीक है, तब जा करके वो फिर से धरती का पुनर्जन्म होगा. ओके, तो गॉड नोज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, बिकॉज बिफोर दिस ऑल्सो अ लॉट ऑफ मिथ्स वर देयर. आप लोगों ने भी सुना था कि 2020 में ये प्रलय आ जाएगा, वो आ जाएगा, ये वो, तो आया तो लेकिन दूसरे फॉर्म में आया, ठीक है, लेकिन डिस्ट्रक्शन तो हुआ ही है. जैसे COVID-19, इट इज़ नो लेस देन प्रलय और इट इज़ नो लेस देन एनी ऑफ द नेचुरल कैलामिटीज. ओके, बट स्टिल व्हाट वी आर सीइंग इज दैट इनडायरेक्ट इफेक्ट ऑफ नेचर कैन बी सीन हियर. ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी हियर व्हाट इज लेफ्ट स्क्रीन शेयरिंग. ओके, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स, चूज योर आंसर्स फ्रॉम द हेल्प बॉक्स. अनुम्बैक इज अ मार्सुपियल विदाउट अ पाउच. द लार्जेस्ट स्पीशीज ऑफ आर्बोरियल प्राइमेट्स आर द बोर्नियन ओरैंगुटांस. The black widow is a kind of spider. If you remember, we have seen this also, or you would have seen this in the class 6th book, if you remember it. The dash, the whale shark is huge but harmless, is the largest living fish in the world. The claws of a bird of prey are called talons. The spider web is one of the strongest naturally made fibers. The collie is a dog breed which was used commonly in Great Britain for herding sheep. The largest member of the cat family is the Siberian tiger. Okay, next, moving ahead to the fact files. So we have here the Galapagos penguins show a curious behavior. The young adults prefer to stay near their parents asking for food even after they are old enough to feed themselves, but the parents are willing to oblige only when they have plenty. Okay. Okay, many species like the Bornean orangutans are now facing the threat of extinction. Extinction का मतलब क्या होता है पहले ये समझिए, फिर मैं आपको आगे की चीज़ें बताता हूँ. ओके, द मीनिंग ऑफ एक्सटेंशन इज दैट इज ऑन द वर्ज ऑफ डेंजर बेसिकली, ठीक है, कि खत्म होने की कगार पे हैं. जैसे लाइक आवर डायनासोर्स, ओके, थे, ठीक है, बट नाउ आर दे प्रेजेंट? नो, दे हैव कम्प्लीटली डिसअपियर्ड फ्रॉम द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ. ओके, सो दिस इज वॉट द मीनिंग ऑफ एक्सटेंशन इज देयर, कि अगर अभी के रिसोर्सेज को हम लोगों ने सस्टेनेबल तरीके से यूज़ नहीं किया, ठीक है, आप किसी भी फील्ड में ले सकते हो, ठीक है, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी हुआ, ठीक है, रिसोर्सेज हुए, टेक्नोलॉजी हुआ, वाटर हुआ, ठीक है, बेसिकली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. ओके, अगर आप नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज को अच्छी तरीके से नहीं यूज़ करते हैं, सस्टेनेबल तरीके से नहीं यूज़ करते हैं, तो कोई गारंटी नहीं है कि आपके फ्यूचर जनरेशन, मतलब जब आपके बच्चे होंगे, ठीक है, आगे चल करके जब आप पेरेंट्स बनेंगे, तो वेदर दे आर गोइंग टू गेट द सेम फ्रीडम और नॉट. ठीक है, जैसे अभी आपको लेविशली लाइफ मिल रही है कि हाँ, आपका जब मन करे आप पानी पी सकते हो, जितना मन करे गिरा सकते हो, जितना मन करे थ्रो कर सकते हो, हो सकता है ये सिनेरियो आगे चल करके ना रहे. ओके, वेदर जस्ट लाइक योर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और जस्ट लाइक योर मोबाइल प्लान्स, यू विल बी गेटिंग द वाटर एज वेल. ओके, रिचार्ज इट एंड गेट इट. सो नथिंग कैन बी थॉट ऑफ. ओके, एनीथिंग कैन हैपन. सो इट इज़ बेटर टू प्रिपेयर योर सेल्फ अकॉर्डिंगली, बेटर टेक ऑल द नेसेसरी प्रिकॉशंस, डोंट वेट फॉर द अदर्स, डोंट लुक फॉर द अदर्स. ओके, कोई मतलब नहीं है, ठीक है, दूसरों का देखेंगे तो आप वही देखते रह जाएंगे. तो अपने आप से मतलब रखिए, ठीक है, वो ज़्यादा जरूरी है. स्टार्टिंग विद दिस, नाउ आई टोल्ड यू आई विल बी शोइंग यू सम ऑफ द पिक्चर्स हियर, सो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू दैट, प्लीज हैव अ लुक ओवर इट. Now what is this? This was also a kind of accidental only. Okay, I have not grown this thing intentionally. I bought some of the cucumbers from the market and I kept it inside the fridge and I forgot to consume it. Okay, when I opened it after a week or something, I found this what happened into my refrigerator in the vegetable tray. If you can see here, this entire cucumber is being covered by the activity of our microorganisms, and basically this is the fungus which is doing it. Okay, so now if you can see here, basically what I think is this is the fungus only. Okay, because bacteria don't make the colonies in this way. Okay, so this is what you can see. If you can see, this is the fine thread like structures, very fine, and slowly and slowly it is covering the entire cucumber, so that after covering it, it starts consuming the inner parts of it, that is the internal parts, and finally you will be left behind with nothing but some of the flies or some of the more microorganisms. Okay, I'll be showing you some more pictures related to this only. If you can see here, these, you can see very thin fiber like structures are there, and this is the real image. This is not the any, what you can say, the artificial image or the Google image which has been taken from somewhere else. Okay, no, This is the natural image which has been accidentally formed and finally captured by my cell phone. So please, I request you, you also can do this activity. I'm not telling you to do it from the entire ones, as my 3 or 4 has been damaged. I'm telling you to just take a piece of it or half of it. That is more than enough to carry out your activity or experiments. Okay. So one more we have here, this one also. Here also you'll be able to see the basic fine thread-like structures only, which are very strong here, okay, from their point of view, okay. So this was there for the pictures. Now let us move ahead with the current affairs, okay. Okay, so in the current affairs, what we have, that is the very first one, that is this part, okay. Yes, starting from the downward section, we have here, that is Pranab Mukherjee, who is the Indian politician who served as the 13th president of India from 12 to 17. And after spending 5 decades in the political career, he has been a senior leader in Indian National Congress and has occupied several ministerial portfolios in the government of India. He was born on 11th of December 1935, Meerut, and he died on 31st of August 2020, New Delhi. Okay. So this was about our honorable president, that is Pranab Mukherjee, and this Meerut is what? It is a area or the region in West Bengal whose pin number is 731302, okay, where he was born. That is, he basically belonged to West Bengal, okay. Height was this much. Spouse means basically the name of the wife here, Subra Mukherjee. Previous offices, basically the President of India and many more. Okay. Okay. Starting with this. Okay. India and Russia were announced as the joint winners of the FIDE Chess Olympiad on August 30, 2020, after Nihal Sarin and Divya Deshmukh lost connections to their games in the second round and have to forfeit. Okay. Mustafa Adib, Lebanon's ambassador to Germany, is set to become the country's next prime minister after he was named by 4 former Lebanon prime ministers as their choice for the post. Now let me tell you that this Lebanon is the name of the country, okay, and it is the country in the Middle East region, okay. Just try to get some more information about this. And this Mustafa Adib is going to become the prime minister of this Lebanon country, okay. Moving ahead with this, that is our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi on August 30th, 2020 announced that September will be observed as the Nutrition Month. He made the announcement in his monthly Mann Ki Baat radio program, where he talked about the importance of nutritious diet, especially in children and students, and also he talked about the nutritional diet related to the pregnant women. Okay. Next one, this I have already told you in the very beginning. India has become the first country in the world to cross the mark of 18,000. This is the report of 31st, and on second, again we have the second highest record, that is 79,000 something was there. Okay, so this was all for today. Okay, now let me share this part. Okay, so what we have done, we have completed this 2-page numbers, that is the bookish part. We completed our this one also. What do we say to this? We completed our bookish part, current affairs, and also I showed you the one of the microorganisms, that was fungus. Okay, so this was all for today. One more thing I would like to share you, that is related to government only. Now see, as I told you, I informed you that Africa, it became the polio free region, okay, after a long time. इनिशिएटिव टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट, ठीक है, जो हमारे सरकारी अस्पताल्स होते हैं, ठीक है, वहाँ पे वैक्सीनेशन होता है, ठीक है, और आप देखते होंगे कि ब्लॉक से या फिर कहीं से कुछ औरतें, ठीक है, आती हैं एक छोटा सा बॉक्स लेकर के आप लोग को पोलियो पिलाने के लिए, ठीक है, या फिर छोटे बच्चों को पोलियो पिलाने के लिए, क्योंकि आप लोग की एज तो जा चुकी है. इट इज़ ओनली अप टू 5 years, आई होप, ओके, सो बेसिक और 3 years मे बी. तो ये क्या है, दिस इज़ वन ऑफ द इनिशिएटिव ऑफ द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ओनली, ओके, एंड ऑन दैट गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल्स, ठीक है, सरकारी अस्पताल में ये वैक्सीनेशन फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट होता है, और द कॉस्ट इज वेरी लेस, दैट इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 10 or 20 रुपीज इज देयर. बट वॉट वी प्रेफर टू गो टू द प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स वेयर द सेम वैक्सीनेशन कॉस्ट अराउंड 2000 और 1000 और इवन मोर देन दैट. ओके, बट क्या है वो एक हमारी ह्यूमन टेंडेंसी बन गई है कि होता क्या है, जैसे जो दिखता है वही बिकता है, ये एक बहुत ही फेमस सेइंग है. ठीक है, तो हम क्या करते हैं, हम जब प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स में जाते हैं तो वहाँ बहुत अच्छे, ठीक है, मतलब लाइटिंग्स, एवरीथिंग, सिटिंग अरेंजमेंट, ठीक है, फिर एसी चैम्बर एंड एवरीथिंग, फिर आपके सामने फ्रिज में से वैक्सीन निकाला जाता है, लगा के दोबारा रख दिया जाता है. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द टैंट्रम्स विच आर बीइंग डन बाय द प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स. I'm not telling you forcefully to just go and have the vaccination there in the government hospitals, but I would request you as well as your parents to just have a look over it, okay? Because that is much more cheaper and at the same time that is much more reliable. एक चीज ये जान लीजिए आप भी कि जितनी भी वैक्सीन्स होती हैं, ठीक है, या फिर जितनी भी दवाएँ होती हैं, जो गवर्नमेंट सप्लाई होती है, दैट इज़ योर ओरिजिनल मेडिसिन और द ओरिजिनल वैक्सीन्स. यू शुड नॉट हैव एनी डाउट रिगार्डिंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ दोज वैक्सीन्स. बस ये रहता है कि उनका मेंटेनेंस थोड़ा सा गड़बड़ रहता है, एंड दैट मेंटेनेंस हैज़ टू बी डन बाई द पीपल हु आर हैंडलिंग इट. ठीक है, जैसे उन्हें बॉक्स मिला रहता है, उसमें बॉक्स में आइस बॉक्स उसको बोलते हैं बेसिकली, ठीक है, तो वो लोग उसी में रखते हैं. लेकिन हम प्राइवेट में क्या करते हैं, उन्होंने यूज़ किया फिर दोबारा उसको फ्रिज में रख दिया. वो लोग ऐसा नहीं करते हैं, मतलब वो फ्रिज में आइस बॉक्स में ही रखते हैं, जब तक लगाना है उसको तब तक उसे बाहर रखेंगे, एंड फाइनली आफ्टर दैट दे आर गोइंग टू कीप इट इन दैट सेम आइस बॉक्स. सो प्लीज़ आई वुड प्रेफर और आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू टू जस्ट हैव अ लुक ओवर इट, सो दैट नॉट ओनली यू आर गोइंग टू सेव अ लॉट ऑफ मनी फ्रॉम दिस, बट एट द सेम टाइम यू आर गोइंग टू जस्ट बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एज वेल, बिकॉज दिस ऑल इनिशिएटिव्स आर बेसिकली डन बाई द गवर्नमेंट ओनली. ठीक है, क्योंकि अगर आप देखो ना तो बहुत सारी ऐसी चीज़ें हैं कि हम गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में पढ़ना नहीं चाहते हैं लेकिन नौकरी हम गवर्नमेंट की ही करना चाहते हैं. ठीक है, ठीक है, सरकार की दवाइयाँ नहीं लेना चाहते हैं, ठीक है, सरकार का वैक्सीनेशन नहीं करवाना चाहते हैं लेकिन डॉक्टर सरकारी बनना चाहते हैं. ठीक है, तो वाई दिस इज देयर. ठीक है, तो ये सारी चीज़ें हैं. तो जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट एंड जस्ट एन्जॉय योर लाइफ विथ proper timetable and study properly. That's all for today. Till next class, be safe, take all the necessary precautions and please protect yourself from this COVID-19. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.